Rest in peace, Tupac.
This goes out to the franchise fam, to those working remote. This is a quote to all those with a dream impacted by C-19. Come on.
I see big changes when I wake up in the morning and I ask myself. Feels like in the past I cast myself. Someone should really sit you down and warn you about how this would ultimately transform you. While we cannot personally escort you, we are all here, ready to support you. I don't want to wait until my next life to take on a jet flight or check in for my next hotel night or wait around for all you to get your heads right. No matter how it seems, don't forget about your dreams. We'll help you and your team make your way downstream. I'd like to propose a toast to seeing you up close and gross at the next event we host, taking a shot at the next goalpost. So here's to not running out of dough and reemerging before the next show. I guess that's just the way it is.
Things will never be the same.
They'll never gonna be the same.
That's just the way it is.
Hey, everybody. Every year I always tell Brad I'm not going to be his pet monkey. I'm not going to be his entertainment for the show. And often I'm able to extract amazing concessions from he and now his family and Ryan Hicks to do almost anything I want them to do in consideration for doing one of these things. And here I found myself, no friends, family, or studio. But you get it as it is, homemade. And, you know, sort of like a bad Milli Vanilli lip sync. But again, on the upside, in terms of existing webinar entertainment, which to this point consisted of making fun of people's backgrounds and outfits, this is, I think, you know, still rated up pretty high there. This is the moment where I'd say, does everybody like dinner? Woo! And you go, yeah, we love dinner. And I would say now, like, what did you have? Did you have anything like a Brad Fishman menu? Did you have sliders with 22 kinds of sauces? Did you have some kind of gourmet tater tots? Certainly some shrimp, some pan of water, some wine that you can't buy in the store, and maybe some aged scotch. Or perhaps Brad's rooftop entertainment, which follows. And then I might have asked you about the Gino's runs I knew people did for cheesesteaks late night. But as you know, we are virtual, aren't we, Brad?
Well, first thing, you know, this COVID thing has been a very interesting thing, but I guess the one good thing out of COVID was I did not have to do that video. I'm sure Michelle looked way better in a black dress than I would. But in reality, you know, I'm glad you still did it. I'm even happier I was not part of it. But, you know, as I told Sherry last night would have been the opening cocktail party. And tonight would be the party. And I kind of feel like the bride's father, because this is something I look forward to every year. Our parties get better and better every year, and it's not there. We're going to have to wait till next year, reschedule it. But this is something we're going to continue. The networking is so important to us and the relationships people meet. So we will be back next year, I promise. So with saying that,
I would say this, Springboard has been evolving, and we're going to thank a lot of people in a minute, but just, it was a thing we kept watching other iterations of webinars and watching new disease these diseases named and created as people experience various degrees of web nausea or web suicide. So we gave Springboard a haircut and we tried to retain the things that made it great from our entrepreneurial profiles. We've condensed all our programming into roundups. The roundups are all intended to seed the mentoring sessions, and they're hosted by franchisors, trying to at least point out to them, to you, what the issues have been for them, and hopefully give you information to pursue through the pods. But we're proud of our pods. We did the legal pods yesterday, and Brad, I'll let you comment on that first as a non-lawyer.
I think they turned out great. And they were phenomenal. It was 25% more than we expected. So it was good to try to go through some of the, as Lane will probably attest to, I'm a PR person and Lane is a lawyer. We are not technology geniuses. So we're doing the best we can please be patient with us, but I promise you the knowledge that you're going to get and the ideas, you know, I was sitting through, and some of the big questions about item 19 are questions that all of us have. How, what's going to happen next year? Fran Dev is something we always have to cover because it's really important. So please be patient with us. Make sure you do download the app, Springboard 2020. And Lane, you want to show them the t-shirt?
Yeah, so I mean, hopefully all of you who registered early enough received a t-shirt and our contest card, and we have been receiving submissions. You'll see them through the program. It's what will distinguish us. Certainly, I don't know if you ever got a free gift to a free event, but we didn't want to, we retain this. People love this about us. We see people send us photos of themselves and selfies and other people wearing them in amazing locations. And
all over the world.
All over the world. And we wanted to encourage you to make your before and after videos. Just to be crystal clear, we need a picture of you doing something in your regular outfit or whatever outfit you want. And then another video standing in the same place with you in this t-shirt. And so those are entered for a cash prize where you will actually be able to touch and feel some Brad Fishman money, because Brad is putting cash on the barrelhead for people who do an amazingly creative job, and we'll be sure to reward you. Now, don't miss this opportunity to be in our PR campaigns and our social media campaigns going forward. It's a little daunting, but while people have used the word TikTok, they're just before and after videos. And we've had some amazing help from Robert Brewski and pulling them all together and assembling them in content that will wow you later. But
you will see some of the outfits later, but we want you to know, please send them in. We would love to get them in there, and we will feature them tomorrow because it's a lot of fun. I actually did it, which is, as Lane knows, it's not my favorite thing, getting into costumes, but you know, we're going to have fun with this. Please tune in for tomorrow, because as I like to call, Lane calls it his little shtick, we will be doing more stuff tomorrow. We're going to have fun with this. There's some great information, but we want to have fun with it. You know, and I'll reiterate, 3:00 Eastern time, these pods will be coming in. I promise you they'll be phenomenal. You will have great information. We have phenomenal mentors and great people, and they're going to be come with questions, because that's what we're here for. We're here to see people succeed into this. We've heard enough negative things going on about the franchising industry. We're here to see it grow. We're going to talk about lead generation later. We have Anthony Geisler joining us in a little while, who can tell you some great things about how he's growing. And let's be honest, in a very tough industry, but that's not daunting to him.
Let me just say that, you know, with great success comes opportunity and obstacles. So we have 435 people signed up for the sessions in the program, 353 franchisors, 200 C-suite executives from the franchisors, 18 multi-unit franchisees. If you've ever been to our event, we took all the people that would have otherwise done the 35 opposed sessions, and they've all agreed to host mentoring sessions. You would be a fool to miss this opportunity. Even if you think you have the world figured out, you should listen to what other people haven't figured out. When you get on the pods and you see the caliber of the folks on them, it's like I was thinking this morning, like a mini YPO meeting. When we did the legal pods yesterday, I'll tell you what I observed. Everybody showed up, and everybody showed up prepared. And it let us start right on time and get right into people's business. And people took it seriously. And you should, before you, you know, I don't know, I think, feel that we're blessed to be able to have all these people sort of turn up and to make this virtual event different. And so we're just trying to, all we want to do is be graded on those mentoring pods. We'll need a little patience. We have some great stuff to entertain you, but try to log on before 3 so that you, the last minute background architecture can be completed to put you in there. But our numbers are amazing. And even without the ice sculptures and chandeliers, Brad, I think this is going to be just an amazing, yeah. Amazing.
Before we go on, this is going to be a very timed event. So we're trying to do this. Obviously, we know people don't want to sit there for 7 hours going through programming. So we'd be remiss if we didn't thank Tony, Joan and Jack and their team, Andrew and Lisa, Jam, and all the moderator sponsors and our speakers, because Without them, this could never come about. And we're looking forward to next year. So please make sure that you have all the Zoom information. If you don't, because at 3 o'clock, you are going on to a new Zoom thing. I know they're going to discuss this later too, but please let us know, because there will be switching Zoom accounts. So be a little patient with us. You're going to get to see some of the video, TikTok, whatever we want to call it with that. And now we want to start turning it over.
Just Brad, make sure that people have their, you need to find the email with the links that we sent out, and you need to have that handy so that you don't have to go fishing around for the links. It's a little bit cumbersome. Sorry we couldn't keep you on one link, but this is the most efficient way to do it to get us where we need to end up. And so, you know, we're not trying to wow you with fancy stuff. We're trying to get you in a room with other people that can help you and you can help them. Think of us as a comfortable pair of shoes. But hopefully, in terms of dress code, as we approach the pods, you can certainly wear whatever you want. You can certainly wear any other springboard t-shirt. Tomorrow at 3, we're going to ask you to actually wear your actual springboard t-shirt, any one you have or the one you just got. We're going to maybe try to do some kind of photo op. But we're not, we know you're home. We were laughing like when people get all dressed up and on a green screen, and we know you're home. You're not a weather forecaster. We know that you're there. We really want you from the neck up. And so we just want you to be comfortable so that you expose your cameras. This, I didn't have anybody not expose their camera. I couldn't imagine the experience being the same. I'm going to give just the same shout out to Jack and Joan and James and everybody at Aranco for running the back of house of this. It is not easy. And Antonia did a yeoman's job and has done an amazing job remotely. Reaching out and organizing this and making it so Brad and I can just step on and do what we want to do. And of course, Jam, I know I tortured you from ClickText in terms of, you know, my daily changes, and Robert Brewski for helping me with anything requiring the use of technology. All right. Be careful. Pay attention to the schedule. It's a little different. Tomorrow starts at 1. But otherwise, I think we're great.
Hello, my name is Jason Pfeiffer. I'm the editor-in-chief of Entrepreneur Magazine. And as always, since the very beginning, we are so excited and happy to be co-hosting this great event, Springboard. Now, you probably know us as the producers of the Franchise 500 list, which, by the way, get your applications in now. We are literally starting to work on that issue as we speak. But we are, of course, doing a lot more than just producing that list. We are constantly, myself and my team, talking to people in the franchise industry. And this year, of course, has been like no other that we have known. The amount of change, the amount of what's felt like turmoil has been tremendous. Of course, that's why an event like this with its mentorship sessions are so great. It's an opportunity to connect with others in the industry and share tips and tactics. But also, I have to tell you what I have been hearing and what my team has been hearing as we've been talking to people during this time. You know, the way that I see it, we have moved through a number of different phases since everything began in March. We started with the panic phase, very familiar. Then we moved into the adaptation phase and then the new normal phase. And now honestly, what I feel like is happening right now, and I bet is going to be infused into the conversations at Springboard, is the we can't go back phase, because what we found is new opportunity here. But that's the amazing thing, I think, about what has happened in these past few months. It's not like COVID brought some kind of change that we couldn't, and it wasn't, the cats didn't turn into dogs, up didn't turn into down. Instead, what happened is that I think we were all pushed, and particularly the franchise industry was pushed to think very deeply about where new opportunities are, where changes can happen, and in ways been shoved into a future that we might have already been going to, where there are new revenue opportunities and new ways to treat and serve customers. This is, as crazy as it is and how unnerving and unsettling it can be at times, also a real time of opportunity. That's how we've been seeing it. That's what I've been hearing from people. And that's the way that we've been covering. And I'm so excited to continue to talk and look with people and to watch as the industry and individual franchises evolve. I am sure there is so much for you all to talk about. So thank you for engaging with us. Thank you for being here today. We are always so excited to be in touch with great, ambitious, future thinking franchisors, which of course you all are, for being here and having these conversations. So have a great springboard, and we'll be in touch soon.